gerçekten Türk milleti bir Türk takımını yurt dışına yollarken çok iyi destekliyor. Biz de bunların karşılığını vermek istiyoruz en iyi şekilde. Asıl All-Star'a kalıp hani bütün dünya...
Welcome back to Barcelona. We've dragged Vedius back to the desk, and Turkey is about to take on Latin America South in our next one-for-all matchup. Now, as with most of the matchups today, the stakes here are pretty high for both sides as well.
Yeah, they certainly are. I mean, if LAS win, then Oceania is out. They're done so. I'm afraid, Frosk, that will be it for your hopes and dreams. I can hear Rusty just saying another day in the office for him. But it's just, it's a shame really because I feel like there's so much pride in the Oceanic team. I know every time I speak to Spawn,
okay,
he's sitting
there. We talk about Oceania in every segment. Talk to me about Latin America. Their pride matters too.
Of course, their pride matters too. They are a very talented team. I feel like they've surprised quite a few people. I for one, didn't really expect them to come out as strong as they have done. But they have had a very, they've done a very good job.
Yeah, I mean, you have to think the last two international wildcard events, they came seventh in both of them. Last time they were invited to All-Stars, however, they did get third. They come in here as like total underdogs, like really off the radar, because everyone's looking at CIS, Turkey, Japan now really being surprising, and Brazil is kind of your top favorites, and no one expected these guys to come out and just blow people up.
Of course, the additional fact there is that if Turkey win here, they do lock first seed, and of course, the players are now almost ready to pick their champions, so let's hand it over to our casters to get this one for all started.
Thank you so much, Sifu. We are getting ready to go here on the castle desk, and I have brought Rusty along with me. Of course, my name is Richard Polskam, and we are getting ready here and getting underway for another one-for-all fiesta.
It definitely is a fiesta, I think the best way to describe it. We've seen a couple of interesting matchups so far, and who knows what's going to happen next.
Who knows, Rusty, but we are getting set for our third match of the day, so let's take a look at the players lining up to compete. Beginning with the Turkish squad representing Team Fire, it will be Elwind in the top lane representing Dark Passage. In the jungle, Crystal from Team Aurora. Mid lane, Naru from Supermassive. Zeitnot as ADC from Dark Passage. And their support, who could forget, Dumbledoge from Supermassive.
A super team in and of itself, but on the opposition side from Team Ice is Latin America South. And in the top lane for this team is Helior from Furious Gaming, Kleitos in the jungle from Isurus Gaming, Plugo from Chaos Latin Gamers, Rangelus from Hafnet Esports, and Bear, their support from Chaos Latin Gamers also.
Absolutely two powerhouse teams. Of course, Turkey only really playing for seeding here, as they have done very well so far in the tournament. If they win this game, they will lock that first seed. Whereas on the opposite side, if they win, something less than stellar happens for some people here on the caster team.
Yeah, there is a chance that LAS play for that first seed, and Oceania is entirely removed from the tournament's contention whatsoever. Of course, Turkey, they may be already in that first seed. There's a lot of pride that is on the line. You heard it in their, I guess, video before, talking about how important it is for them to represent their region properly. But because they're already considered in that top spot, they're qualifying. I said, who knows what we might see. We might see something absurd.
We might. I mean, from what we've seen already today, we saw the Zac. I knew we were going to see Zac come up. Because you take a look at the champions, it's like, who's the tankiest, most obnoxious champion on the list?
Mm-hmm.
Zac. You can't kill him. They actually had a really cool strategy ready to go. The Brazilians just like brought out the ZZ Rot and used that as the method of pushing. And Ezreal just couldn't do anything. And actually, a lot of those champions on the list can't do anything against Zac.
I think it was a big mind game as well between Brazil and Oceania. Of course, very close friends. We saw them hugging it out after the games had ended. There's a very real chance that they knew Ezreal was coming and they had a plan ready to go.
Alright, so what's it gonna be? We've been kind of doing a little bit of theory crafting on what could be brought out. Of course, Lee Sin, Graves was the first matchup, followed by Ezreal and Zac. So those have been taken. So are we gonna see something new or something along the same lines?
I certainly hope it's not Vayne. Of course, that could be very exciting. I'd say there's at least lots of kills and deaths everywhere to be seen, as our ice side have got their eyes set on Corki.
Yeah, I mean, outside of the AD carry, you have to feel there'll be a lot of Vayne spawning going on if they do decide to lock in the Vayne. Corki, on the other hand, I mean, I guess you can have like a hybrid. You can have like ADs and AP carries, and I guess a tank.
Dumbledoge's
and initiator
Rebel
as well.
Not two of them have rebelled, but Ezreal wins in
right,
the end.
Okay. So Ezreal once again. Ezreal will probably have a much better time against Corki, which has been locked in for the ice lineup. All right, so an AD carry game and two AD carries who can build both AP and AD.
Yeah, so we're going to see a lot of potentially mixed damage. I'm a big fan of both of these champions because I like to build the AP alternatives myself. I'm a firm believer that the Corki AP build is very strong. But both of them also want to scale and get their items, so we could be here for the long haul. I guess it comes down to how they start to play these games out, because AD carries against AD carries, they always have, you know, lifesteal, range auto attack damage, they've got pretty good wave clear to speak of, and it's very hard to get things going as a group.
It actually just depends on the item builds and how they decide to play out the game, because if they do decide to go for like AP build, you'll see Ezreal's just going in constantly, there'll be a lot of kills, or if they go for more of like a blue build, then yeah, you're looking at more sustained backline damage, trying to poke away at the Corki. Corki does the same thing, goes in for the missile barrage as his way of harass, and then we have like a siege game. So it really just depends on how the players are feeling today and how they want to build.
I'm most excited as well for the packages that Corki will be getting around that 8 minute mark, because five of them getting a package. I don't know how it works, but like, firstly, how do they look in the spawn? And are there five packages?
That's
and
true.
Can only one person pick up the package if there's only one? And who actually gets priority? There's a really big question mark on that.
We are going to find out. I want to see if someone goes like a kind of tankier build as their initiator, and they just send in initiator Corki to get things rolling onto the Ezreals. But we'll find out. So, funny enough, the composition's all Ezreal and all Corki. At this point, usually I'd be asking you for a breakdown of the lineup, but I think it's a little bit different than this one.
I guess we have to firstly look at the skin battle that we'll be seeing. So a lot of Pulse Fire Ezreals on the side of the TCL. The opposition actually has Arcade Corki everywhere. So personal fan of this. And look at the...
it's
they're
glorious.
Walking in a line. Oh, it's amazing.
Do a barrel roll. Get in there.
Oh, one did. Oh, there you go.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
They actually do barrel rolls when walking.
Well, some of the Ezreals have mastered the emote spam, and I think we're going to have a head-to-head.
Oh, no.
Toss getting bodied with these Qs coming in from Team Fire. And Naru is going to be leading the charge into the jungle. Fast bombs are coming out. Zeitnot does not want any of this. And they're going to back to base. They are sitting on top of a ward, though, so any Corki who hasn't used their fast bomb already can stop all of this. Wara wants it, but he's getting zoned away by the flurry of mystic shots coming from Team Fire.
The recall animation spam as well coming out of the TCL team. I don't know if they actually ever do want to recall. They're just praising the Ezreal gods.
They are praising something. Not sure if it's the sun.
They could have hologram dance battles too.
They could. But they have learned how to
spam
the remotes.
Yeah.
One is bad enough.
I'm not enjoying watching all of these.
No, it is. It's very much hurting my head.
Oh, man,
all right,
thank you.
Thank you. Thanks so much, Observers, for getting us away from that. Let's see if Corki has another obnoxious emote to spam. All right, so we do have a split in terms of keystones for at least some of the Ezreals going for that further of battle versus Thunderlord. So you can expect the Thunderlords maybe to be going towards a more AP-centric build, where the Corkis maybe just all going AP.
Yeah, there's a very real chance they do. Of course, the Gatling Gun also instantly procking Thunderlords, AP or AD aside. Deathfire touches considerable amounts of damage, but again, they're against Ezreal, so this is where the difference between Ezreal Masteries and what Corki's want has come to play here. You don't necessarily need that Warlords. They just want to do more AD damage.
You've got to feel as well, if you're the Corki players on this one, it's just like, maybe I do want more AP just in terms of our lineup. Maybe we have one guy who goes AD, but if the Ezreals decide to go for like an Iceborne Gauntlet or a more traditional quote-unquote Ezreal build, then going for AP might help them out.
Yeah, there's a very real chance, of course. One thing we have to, I guess, severely point out is the ability that an Ezreal has to jungle. We saw it highlighted in how effective it can be. In that last game, one champion that cannot do it is Corki. Can't really kite the camps, doesn't really have a lot to offer, and will run very low whilst doing the jungle.
Here comes the level 3 Crystal Gank from the jungle, and they're going all in onto Plugo. He's going to have to burn his flash, and Fire come out victorious in that one. Talking about jungling, Kleytos is giving it his damnedest. He is giving it a good shot.
Yeah, he tried the red.
It didn't work out very well.
Now the red's potentially going to...
Whoa, Wara dropping low. He'll have to flash away, but as the first blood coming in, Zeitnod will finish him off. Bear not going to be so lucky. Flashed after.
No,
double
dodge.
There's the auto attack onto the minion. One kill at least to the lineup, but... Always at the second.
That's a hands-off keyboard moment from Dumbledore. Auto attacks a minion and instantly holds position. It's the sign of someone who might be tilted already. And at 3 minutes in the game, the Turkish side showing how strong Ezreal can be in comparison to Corki.
Usually Dumbledore is the tilter, though. He inflicts tilt upon other people, but we'll see that one more time.
Yeah, we do get to see this. The E forwards, I believe it was, from the Ezreal that secures it. There's a lot of initial upfront burst that actually locks down the kill, basically, where this is a... You can see the exact moment that he hit a minion and realized that he made a big mistake in held position.
Well, the gank continue from Crystal. Heliot having to flash away. He's burning out from the red buff, but it's not going to be lethal.
You've got minions. Run, Plugo.
Yeah, did not want to be between that tower and the wall there, so we'll Valkyrie back behind his minions. I want to see how Kleytos is doing, because he is currently on 6CS, which is not many camps cleared.
He did get the red after a recall. Okay. He took it on. Second time was the charm, at least.
Well, he's got that going for him, which is nice.
I think the difference as well is he started at the blue buff. Yeah. He didn't get as efficient a clear as Crystal.
That's true. Yeah, Crystal, that was Crystal clear. Bot lane, Dunwall Doge. The instant damage coming out from the Thunderlord's proc.
Not sure why they're corky, all things considered.
Like, that's why I said yesterday when Edward locked it in against Tam Kench. The idea in theory is good, but...
And if they do go AP, they want level 16, because that's when they're the strongest.
Not sure how I feel about a game in One For All when you're saying, my power spike is at level 16.
Well, okay, so like AP Corki is like the old AP Kog'Maw, right? Like, right. You're good, like you still do stuff. When you hit 16, you win the game.
Yeah.
That's what they're looking for if they go AP.
So we're talking more of like a time bomb, like, yeah.
Okay. Whereas Ezreal's just always good until he gets a tier, and then maybe Corki gets a Sheen to the tier.
It drops off a little bit.
Yeah.
And it gets better again. Crystal.
Good game.
Third time's the charm, perhaps, onto Plugo. He knows he doesn't have flash. The Valkyrie is a double jump forwards, followed up by Mystic Shots. Crystal looking for the last auto, finds him. Plugo will bite the dust. 2-0 to TCL.
Everywhere we look, there is an Ezreal winning. Even the jungle camps are beating the Corki right now, except that he's bottom. He has red buff, and they are low.
Uses the popcorn to get into lane. Will follow up with his E. Dumbledore's taking a lot of damage. He'll have to sacrifice himself. But Zaytnon not going to be lucky either. Kleytos and Bear coming in.
The cannon.
Minion. Oh, Bear! But he gets executed. No one damaged him.
Bear dies to minions. How embarrassing. But they do get the kill. So Corki's biting back.
Hang on. Noro just Kleytos finished off Kleytos. Yeah, sure. Top lane trading blows. Heliot up against Elwynd. And we're only 6 minutes in and 5 kills. Okay, here's a replay of the bottom lane. All right, hopefully we see what happens mid lane too.
Yeah, so lots of damage, honestly, but the heal was good. Zaytnon trying really hard to get the kills, tanks a little bit too much. And that's where the, I guess the explosive plant play from Kleytos comes in. Doesn't have to use his Valkyrie to get over the wall. And so he has it to close the distance and use that red buff effectively. Gets a kill on Dumbledore. Zaytnon realizes that there's no escape after this flash. And uses his minions, but his minions wanted Bear, not Kleytos, and he didn't hit Bear. Scumbag minions.
That was a lot of damage.
It was, actually.
He had a lot of health left. Oh, man. Well, that's pretty good for you, Rusty. You are TCL Rusty in this game, for intents and purposes.
Yeah.
That's the result you want.
It is, yes. As an Oceanic member.
Hang on.
Unbiased caster, Oceanic member.
Absolutely. Okay, so let's analyze some of these builds here, as much as analysis can go. Double tier, coming through.
Yeah, 2 AP Ezreals. I believe in Dumbledore, who's going straight to the AP build, different to the last one that we saw from Rosie. But in a Lichbane rush, actually, as well, from Naru. So they will have mixed damage, which is good. It's not like a Corki's going to build resistances, though, so it doesn't matter too much in that respect. On the other side, they haven't actually bought a whole lot. I'm expecting Kleytos to be the AP Corki. But, you know, that's an AM tome, so we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see about that one. Bear's just like, I just came to this tournament for fun. I'm going to be a support. Has picked up the Frostbang.
Here we go.
Hit by the banana. Mystic shot.
Oh,
another
no.
Banana goes
oh, no.
Wide. Elwynd, dodgeball champion, Heliot 2016. Will live another day.
That was a lot of damage.
Kleytos is closing in, coming into the bot lane.
Whoa, Bear.
In with the initiation, but he's taking a lot of damage in return. Dumbledore will go hard and go in, but not come back out. Zaytnon being followed down, and the fast bomb not landing will be the end of that one.
Zaytnon wants that.
Perhaps in kill range, Zaytnon with a decent amount of mana left, and E
he's
coming
six.
Up any second.
He just ticked six. Watch the ulti.
He's got the ultimate.
Oh, no. Where's he going to aim?
Oh! Doesn't get any of them. did burn the flash. Plugo closing
really...
in.
He has been baited.
Not long for this world.
He's all in.
Yeah. Oh, he finds Wara! Okay, he still had heal, by the way.
He made the best out of that, I suppose. Gives Lightning credit for that one.
Yeah.
There was someone flanking him, so he had no choice but forward, or he would just die. Going backwards, as the answer has been there. One package.
Maybe they're stacked on top of each other. We have to just, like, stay up there and take a look.
Okay, they are stacked. Yep, they're stacked. There's a lot of packages on top of each other.
Yeah.
We just saw one of them use theirs, so that explains everything.
Ah. I was wondering why it was so yellow.
It was super yellow, yeah. All right. They aren't exactly using them in unison just yet, but they have them.
I feel like you have to, right? Like, as soon as they spawn, you're going five Corkies. Like, that's the crux of your strategy.
But like, the Ezreal's response right now should be to freak out and run away every single time, because the second they pick up a package, it announces it to you.
That is true, but I just want an awesome moment when all Corkies group up, form a V, and just charge at the Ezreal's.
They could make like a tic-tac-toe board, almost.
They could do that. Kratos coming in with his first package, Wara and Bear following up with the damage. Lana goes wide, lands onto Bear. Crystal now coming in as well, tossing out his own True Shot Barrage right through the goalposts. Kratos running away. Wara's going to body block for him. And the missiles, the back and forth, the war of attrition. Bear comes out on top.
Oh, here he goes. Plugo is just clearing minions. That's one more package down. And the best thing about the package, right, is you can just do dragon with them. Like, if they actually saved it as five. I think they got a little bit trigger happy and decided to do it early. The amount of skill shots as well, something we haven't really addressed. The winner of this game is the one that hits their skill shots better.
The winner of this game is whoever was best at dodgeball in high school. Plugo, Kratos. They both head over the wall. Crystal, looking for an out, finds two Corkies behind him, jumps over the wall, flash into Zeitnot.
Oh no, this is dodgeball.
Okay, this is not a place you particularly want to be. Bear's going to come in, can't dodge auto-attacks. Crystal now also under fire, but Naru and Dumbledore here to assist. Kratos called out, he's going to have to flash away, but will still meet his end.
He's ghosted.
Double Valkyrie, triple Valkyrie.
That would
Naru
hurt.
Does not want to be stepping in that. And Dumbledore trying to kite after them, but not going to happen. So 6-6 currently in this game. Many kills have gone down. Many skill shots, many missed skill shots.
There's just so many skill shots, Pulse, every single second. Three Corkies throwing their ultimates. But again, we're waiting for those levels on the Corkies. Naru's the biggest deal, I think, at the moment, though. The AP Ezreal.
Whoa-ho! See you later.
Speaking of, thank you, Naru.
Rest in peace, Bear.
4-0-1. That'll be his Lich Bane. We'll have to see if he gets anything else with that. Doesn't look like he's going for a tier build by skipping it. Different to the Oceanic team, and we get to watch something that happened top lane. Oh yes, Elwynn. He's been outplayed. He was in the shop.
Not looking in that place.
Yep, here comes Naru, and again, the AP has Ghost, so scares the crap out of them, and watch the damage he takes.
Yeah, the thing I love about this game mode is that when a replay comes up, I actually don't know what the replay is going to be of, because there's so much action, and in between those actions, like, which fight are we going to see over the last, like, 30 seconds?
Yeah, did not even know that he died top lane, to be perfectly honest with you, because of all the fighting, coincidentally, at the same time on the bottom side of the map.
Yeah, Naru died. Good to know.
Does work. Again.
Okay, so how are the Ezreal? Oh, never mind. Bear's coming in hot. Valkyrie into Valkyrie. Elwynn taking a bunch of damage from the big one. Oh. There's another one. But meanwhile, on the opposite side of the map, of course, Wara's going in onto Crystal. Kratos following after as well. Another Valkyrie, yet another one. And True Drop
double
doesn't
doge
come off in time, but they're going to close in on Double Doge. This should be an easy double for Double Doge.
Oh, he stopped a rocket.
In place. Plugo coming in onto Double Doge. The fish will eat the smaller fish, and in comes Zeitnot to kill off the last Corki, and there's no more Corkies. That's a triple kill coming out.
One by one, they march in, and one by one, they all start to fall, but everybody's dying everywhere except top lane, where Bear and Helio are able to push Elwynn back, and they are looking for a structure. So a strategy is finally here for the LAS region.
Yeah, well, they're going to take the tower. That's good. And now leading in gold, so we have some semblance of a strategy indeed. All right, So who was the first victim? Wara goes in onto Crystal.
Yeah, again, he's a Vayne, so he's always going to go forwards. Yeah. And pay attention to all of the miss-skill shots that start to make the distance here. The difference, not the distance, there's definitely no distance involved.
He didn't go to distance for sure.
And this is one in particular where Angelus throws the rocket, accidentally dodges. And that's why Dumbledoge eventually will fall also, because the return damage that came out of an accidental dodge was too real.
But then so will Bluko. So, yeah. Zeitnot.
Another package
will
though.
Win. Okay, Helior.
They really should synchronize their package cycles.
I'm a little sad that they didn't. I feel like there is a point in the game, maybe mid-game, maybe that level 16 power spike where they'll all decide to go for it. This is a bit ridiculous. there's the Ezreal ultimate coming down into the bottom lane through the river. It's pretty great though, seeing all these mechs just go in against the dragon. Dumbledoge does not want to be here right
this
now.
This is Zaino disgusting.
Needs to run away real fast. Well, Arcane shift out. Return. Ooh. Ooh, hello.
That was a bit off.
Yeah.
Helior also has no health to his name, so maybe could have aimed that way.
As,
still has no health to his name.
Bit of clenching going on in the bot lane. I think we're good. 10 to 10 currently. 1,000 gold advantage. Plugo going in, but it's the bottom lane where Wara wants blood. He wants that Ezreal.
He's not going to get it.
There's a minion wave in the way.
There is indeed. Now there's a runic echo, something we haven't mentioned. Kleytos is the AP. Corki in question, as is Bear.
Ooh.
They all lose a lot of their health. I'm still waiting for that moment also where the Ezreals collapse together.
Plugo's just dead. Naru with the outplay. He's the biggest dead draw right now, but Helior wants to avenge his fallen comrade. Former squadron member.
Watch the... never mind. I was going to say watch the damage because he is an AP Ezreal.
He's
also going the hybrid build. So he'll be doing a lot of Q damage when he connects with the Lich Bane and the Revolver.
He's got to hit something first though.
He does.
Wara. Alright, form up squad. Let's take some towers. Crystal. He's here for tower defense, but he is but an Ezreal. And Zeitnot, probably not the angle he wants to be coming into mid lane right now.
I guess it makes sense though that the Ezreals and Corki should all be not standing next to each other. Because yeah. Again, the AoE skill shots that each team actually presents to their opponent is quite serious. So interestingly enough, we might see like three different flanks, and then it becomes a matter of who's flanking who until someone dies.
That does make most sense.
That's what I do anyway, like, but at the end of the day, there's just Ezreal and Corki's and can instantly die.
That's true. Lugo with the quote-unquote initiate, did not want any of those skill shots coming in. All of the ultimates are available from the Ezreals, so if someone is at 100%, they're in kill range.
Yeah, they're starting to... So there's three of them, roughly four of them mid. I think they're waiting on Naru's, which is the biggest differentiator for the Ezreal ultimates.
Left. Yeah, it should be up in, like, now.
So now they group, and if they find an opportunity to do exactly this as a team...
Ooh, that happens. They only needed one, and the rest of an Ezreal's combo. Helior forces Dumbledoge back. Not only back, he's dead. I didn't even see him disappear. So a one for one, both quote-unquote supports dead in this game.
Oh, Dumbledore's just dead.
Yeah. I thought the arcane shifted away. Turns out he was just dead.
But the siege continues, so we'll see if this can be prevented by a single Corki coming in that should get altered by Ezreal's.
Kleytos does have ultimate, but I'm not sure he wants to go in on that. Tower's dead. Mid-tower down. Okay.
I would never advise running teleport against five Ezreals, because the damage that'll come out when you give them 5 seconds of notice actually scares me. Like, I'm clenching for them. As we get to watch Bear instantly die to a combo.
Bear's like, I'm alright. I've got most of my health.
I'm not alright.
I didn't have most of my health. Oh, and there's Dumbledoge. There's Naru getting shut down, though.
Few
Bear
packages.
Comes in for the old drive-by.
This is the biggest package I've ever seen.
Ooh, Dumbledoge is going AP as well. Yeah, that hurts. Nice Valkyrie from Bear. Good reactions. And this red buff, probably pretty important for the Ezreal squad. They will secure...
Oh, no,
Bear! He needs to get out of dodge. Wara is going to pop the blast pan, but Dumbledore finds him. Goodbye, Bear. Zeitnot as well. Crystal chiming in for the kill. Plugo. Skill shots going wide, going awry. And after that, I can't tell who has the advantage because Plugo's going in after.
No one.
Dumbledore. Oh, he's bleeding out. There's the red buff. Told you it was a good one for the Ezreal.
I think at this stage, while we're saying, you know what, these champions really good with having levels, the exact same time we have to remember that as they get levels, their opposition gets levels, they die quicker, and basically everyone kills everyone, they meet in the middle, and nothing eventuates because they just meet in the middle.
Yep.
Waiting for someone to die near a turret so that something falls. And at this stage, LAS are doing better than the Turkish team at that, because we get to see a lot of damage come out constantly from every direction. It really is like a snowball fight.
It is,
just
but
lobbing stuff everywhere.
Made of plasma, and they hurt.
In rockets.
Yeah, and rockets.
So it's not it's a snowball fight.
It's a not. Futuristic snowball fight. Hello. He's got his ultimate. Oh, he's got his package. I'm still waiting for the package play. Like, I'm sure they have something prepared. You don't pick Corki and then say, you know what, it's going to go in one by one. Just going to pop my package whenever I feel like.
Currently no packages available. It's a right shame.
What else could you do for five packages? You could box them in.
I think, yeah, you could, like, bait the Baron, which is impossible as Corki's. You know what?
He was just having a stroll down river. It's like, I'm going to go back.
Nowhere is safe. No. There is no such thing as safe on Summoner's Rift against global AP Ezreal ultimates.
Those things come up fast as well, because they're constantly hitting things with their Qs.
Yeah, that's the thing as well. Cooldown reduction, so having like a Sheen in your item build, every Ezreal generally will have one of those, means you can throw it out more often. Lucidity also for Naru, so the AP Ezreal is going to have a lot of them.
It's also a mixed bag of damage, right? I'm going to hold that for a second, because I wanted to see Beth wander down.
Dumbledore, I believe. Nope, it was Naru. That was Dumbledore.
It's like,
so much damage.
Which one do I dodge? Because one of them is going to hurt significantly more than the other True Shot Barrage. So if you have the choice of dodging one, it's like, yeah. I'm taking a 50-50.
You don't know which one's going to do more damage in the end.
Is this the AP one or is this the support one? I don't know.
At least with Corki, it's red. Yeah. It's like, you know that that one's going to hurt more anyway, so dodge that.
Exactly. And for the most part, they're all going to hurt.
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, Kleytos has a GLP 800.
He does.
Fair enough, dude.
You do you.
You're a free spirit.
What? I guess he sets up his allies as well. He will be jumping in there.
I look forward to I look forward to the package being used so that he can get in range of the GLP, but otherwise
douse them down and everyone else can land their rockets. Yeah, exactly. We need to see some Ezreals essence flux each other.
All the attack speed. Yeah. Alright, Palugo's ready.
They'll rip apart a tower. They actually have pretty good tower pushing if they're grouped up. Oh.
Palugo was ready.
Yeah, Palugo's going in. So is Helio.
Oh, good flash.
Coming in. Do a barrel roll. Dumbledore, ultimate three! Finds one, looking for the second, but Kleytos with the flank. Crystal finds one onto Plugo. Helio with a return kill. Kleytos chiming in as well, but he's ticking down from the red buff. I think he's...
He's alive.
Good, question mark.
Yeah, he's so he's just barely alive. Naru not actually going to be there, just throws the ultimate out. Essentially the biggest difference, you'd have to say. Helio also not having his teleports. Everything's just chaos. And there are a lot of packages now available. So they can rinse and repeat. And these Corkis are actually starting to push further ahead.
Uh-oh. Wara, bucket. Cheese it. Here comes the police. Here comes Naru. Nah, there's no chance.
There is no opportunity to run from all of that damage. Even pops the
nope.
The cutlass in between all of this. It really is filthy. Just watching all of the damage that they do and the damage that they also take. Like, this is absolute man mode. Synergy. Good flash from Plugo as well to dodge Ezreal ultimates. And you have to kind of keep your eyes for where the heck is Naru's ultimate if it's available. Because that would kill everybody.
That's true.
And it misses everybody.
Oh, we found it. Oh, meanwhile, there was a fight in top lane.
Oh, shot.
Yeah.
That was a really good shot.
Yeah. Goodbye, Elwynn. Elwynn's not had a great game.
No.
But he is playing like a top laner. He's only been sitting in top lane. I don't think he's moved anywhere else, to be honest.
There's very sound logic to say that, you know, playing Ezreals is fine because most people could play the Ezreals, but... Top lane is maybe not familiar with the champion. Mid lane is usually play at AP when they're an AD carry even. Good night.
That was a brave play, but Kleytos might be able to reclaim a kill. Or not. He's pretty dead. Wara was attempting to come in with the package, but his two allies had just lemming their way in. And unfortunately dead.
They have a lot of wave clear though. Like, the Ezreals have a pretty hard time. They will get it, but it doesn't make it easy.
No. The tower was luckily very low, and it wasn't outer tower, so they had that going for them. Zeitnot, the rockets. You need to be careful. Oh, that's actually smart. The Frost Queen's claim.
Yeah, yeah.
From Bert, yeah.
It actually is very smart as Flora.
He saw the montage play and he got the 1-for-1. So, that's alright.
Won't go in the montage. Real, no.
He saw it.
Naru does not have his ultimate. Does have Flash, and it is bare, so.
Anything could happen.
The damage is potentially available. Also, these guys going Hex Drinkers. I'd just like to highlight that I don't appreciate defensive items in an AD carry-off.
Nope. Vettius, I'm sure it's going to go hard on them.
It's understandable if you want to survive, but if you could just dodge the skill shots, you wouldn't have that problem.
Alternatively, you could get good. And there you go. That's the solution.
Absolutely.
Helior. He's waiting in the wings. Waiting for this gank onto mid lane. However, I wouldn't want to gank Naru, because you're not the Predator in this situation.
He has a Hextech Gunblade. The package doesn't mean that much when he one hits you.
7, 2, and 3. Quite big.
He almost needs a Void Staff already, too. That's a shame. It really is a shame.
Yep. Naru, big damage. Helior. He's going to have to burn the package at some point. I'm still waiting for the squadron play. Dormadoze on the way back. He's going full AP. Dormadoze is a mannered people.
Yeah, again, like we're looking at the Ezreal builds this game, and this is almost much more expected. But what are you going to build against Zax in comparison to against a Corki?
Exactly.
You have to try and shred them. Whereas this game, you just want to do damage.
Oh, no. Oh, that actually was not as bad as I was expecting it to be from Pugo.
Damn Hex Drinkers.
Ruining our fun.
He had no extra at that time. So any other Ezreal? Crystal has ulti.
Just standard 14.
Snipe him.
Worry about it. Claytos. All right, we're playing battleships right now. We found a Claytos.
Damn. Oh, that was going to spawn too. Does it?
Oh, okay. I like
Man
the idea.
Can dream. Yeah.
Didn't have the script running. Okay, here come the essence fluxes onto the Ezreals. But here comes
Helior with a teleport flag.
But he doesn't have his package. Claytos does though, he goes in. There's lots of rockets flying everywhere, there's lots of skill shots. Things are happening here, Rusty. Helior, he's getting hit in the side. Claytos looking to follow after as well. What? He's back
no
away.
One dies but Plugo.
I feel like he also just died in the crossfire, to be honest. I don't think anyone was particularly aiming for him. Naru shut down. See you later, raid boss. Wara finds a double kill. Look at me, I am the AD carry of this team, regardless of the game mode, Crystal. He's hunting, he's waiting, he's got his ultimate.
Corkis are at the Baron though. I wonder if Crystal noticed this. It appears that they trust in their ability to do this.
This is actually the perfect time to go for a Baron because so many Ezreal ultimates are down, there's less of a steal chance.
Yeah, and Helior can tank. No, we can't, he's gonna...
Man, one Naru ultimate will kill everyone.
That's
Crystal
one
Crystal coming in, that's one. Looking for the second. Zaynot and Crystal,
they're
the tag
dead.
Team from heaven. Helior, he goes down. Ultimate comes across through the goalpost. Zaynot onto Claytos. Will be coming out on top. Wara. He's low, but not dead. He's recalling. He's being revealed. No chance. Crystal puts him on the floor. 4-4-0. TCL taking the advantage.
It was a nice idea going for the Baron. I will give them that much. However, first thing we have to note is the explosive plant, pure embarrassment that came out of one of the members of LAS. Honestly, I don't remember at this stage. There's 5 Corkis, it's hard to keep up. And because he only went on the spot, he had to use his Valkyrie to get over the wall. And then he was stuck in the pitters. Now it's Turkey's chance, or attempt, as Plugo's spotting them.
Oh, he's rocking. Just one Corki, maybe not to disrupt this. Plugo! Oh, he's getting hit a bunch, but he's got the Hex Drinker. Double Doze with a 1v1 and a finish off. Ultimate team return onto the Baron. We should be able to take it out. Bear is on the hunt. He's feeling grizzly. No, he's backing away. Okay.
This is where you want the packages, Pulse. They're not able to get there. 27 minutes in the game, capitalizing on a mistake from ICE's LAS team. They get a Baron themselves.
They had the potential to completely stop that Baron in its tracks with those packages. Coming straight from base would have had enough time. But even the fact that a team managed to take Baron is a feat in itself.
Here we go. You have to watch the Corki. Helior. I'm helping. I'm not helping. You're dead. Now I've got no Valkyrie left, and I'm stuck tanking the Baron while my team dies. That's your Kodak moment, Helior. Zaynot does do a lot of work here, and also good use of the scrying plant to actually spot Wara. They knew he was stuck because there was a scrying orb on the other side of that bush.
Oh. Nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide. Spit it up a little bit. And we won't see the Ezreals take the Baron, but almost saw a hero play from one of the Corki squad. They still have a lot of wave clear, despite the Baron buff going over to TCL. Corki will be able to shred the resistances. This is so many screenshots.
It's just too hard to keep up sometimes. You just have to let it unfold. Jesus.
I feel like the way that this game is going, when you have 10 marksmen, like, you need to be an FPS caster.
Wait, was it hello? I altered top.
Like, anyone with FPS casting experience would be perfect for this right now. Zaytnon, he's dropping low. He's out of there. Gunned down by the Corkis.
Oh,
Plugo. Luckily, he was behind the minion wave and a couple more Corkis.
And poor Bear has no health to his name. Even with an Abyssal Scepter, he's just losing all of his health under the pressure that Ezreal's are able to provide. Crystal still wants to win the game, so he's going for objectives. As the rest of the Turkish team just want to kill the Corkis.
It's not a bad strategy, to be honest, in this game. LAS have had the Ocean Dragon, which would have to feel as a good pickup, at least in the Wars of Attrition, but it's getting to the point where everyone's doing so much damage. You're going to die pretty much instantly from fall.
We're still waiting, low pulse. Level 16. Corki's ultimate actually does 1-to-1 scaling. So when he hits 16, it gets to the 1-to-1 scaling, whereas it scales up per level. So that's when he really turns on. The damage that he's doing now is still commendable. It doesn't seem to compare, however, to the Ezreals.
How much of like a win condition is getting to level 16 right now for Team Ice? Like, how dead are the Ezreals once you get there?
I mean, it's the only thing they've really got right now against the Baroned up Ezreals, and you want to kill the champions.
Oh! Bear's going in, Bear's going out. Let's give him the high five.
I mean, it's true to Bear form. We saw his Pantheon support earlier in the week.
But he only went in.
Yeah.
There was no going out. It's like, this is great. I actually have an ability to not die every time I want to jump.
Two dashes.
Yeah.
Now, versatility.
Also, the Bear is evolving. The Bear is learning.
I wonder if he'll die from Naru's ult. No, it's going to go mid.
Bear.
That's
see the squishiest member on the team? Well, he's actually, he's adapted. He's picked up the Abyssal Scepter. Who's the squishiest? Plugo, all right. Hopefully there's not another one.
I don't know if there is a squishiest member on the team. They all just take too much damage anyway.
Yeah.
Like, they've all got magic resistance. There's a bit of extra health on Kleytos.
Oof. All right.
That skims
his bumper.
Backside.
Yeah. Zaytnot's got his and Crystal, so they could look for a snipe opportunity. I want to see another assassination from the Ezreals, just like we saw early on to Bear. I feel like 5 Ezreal ultimates will just nuke any of these Corkis, regardless of the Moors.
It definitely will. No Void Staffs, unfortunately, though, just yet. Elwyn will go for this, you would imagine. He's a little bit scared.
Yeah. Not enough.
Whoa!
Over there, Zaytnot.
All right, mate.
A bunch of damage. Wara, steady on. There's the ultimates, there's one, there's two. Crystal, Elwyn, and Dumbledore lining up for the shot.
Wara knows he made a mistake. I think it's safe to say both summoners gone.
Objectively, Plugo takes a bunch of damage in from the Mystic Shots. Bear chased down by Zaytnon. He doesn't want this right now. No man to escape, but there's stray Ezreal ultimates flying absolutely everywhere. Dumbledore fires his. Where's it going? Down mid lane. And Wara, he's coming back. He's coming in for the initiative, but he's too low. He's out of there. Elwyn finished off by Helior. Jump over the wall. He's got the Blast Plant. Crystal, he's trying to find a kill here, but Kleytos has his own package. Tries to deliver the package. They weren't at home.
Those left at the post office.
Yeah.
Ezreals are in.
Ezreals are out there. Definitely doesn't want any more of this, but you can't dodge a homing missile. Finds the double. Oh, baby. Naru coming in. He wants that triple. Plugo 1v1 against Crystal. The flash. And a kill.
The flash was ultimately not necessary. However, he made it look pretty badass, so we'll give him those badass points. Naru and Crystal will be doing a lot of damage to these turrets, as you can see.
Good lord.
There was two minions to accompany them. You give Ezreals an inch and they will take the entire game.
All right, well, War is coming up, so luckily they won't be able to finish this one up. But 33 minutes in, we have 56 kills. And yet another replay for you to feast your eyes on.
And I mean, There's not really a lot you can say about this. It's just skill shots absolutely everywhere. Also, sound effects-wise, they picked the worst possible skins for Ezreal and Corki.
I think you mean the best possible skins.
Well, yeah, it depends what you're after. Yeah. You're right, they are very good. Borangelis is an absolute monster. He always wants to go forwards. But Helier ultimately is the one that gets everything done. Also, a package on Kleytos this whole time. And he waited till then to use it. Not exactly appropriately.
I'll let him off because it's not...
initiation tool. Ah, yes, the package from Corki.
Yeah, Plugo comes in and does a lot of work on the back end of it.
Yeah.
That's not enough, though. It's Crystal. It just looks stylish.
To be fair, it was 1v3, so he got two.
Yeah, he definitely did.
All right, Naru, still the biggest Ezreal.
Mm-hmm.
Who is the biggest Corki? I'd say Wara.
It would be Wara, yeah. I just don't know if Kleytos even had a chance to use his GLP 800. Yeah, the idea here really is that they should just poke both of them, and whoever pokes the best
wins.
Fair.
He can't survive another one. Luckily, there is no more. Ezreal wants to come out! The hidden Corki is apparently not the deadliest, as he was found by the onslaught of Ezreal's.
Now they all go back to base.
And the disgusting amount of skill shot.
Baron, how many packages are there?
All right, boys. Yeah, check this one for
me, Rusty.
There's
a couple there.
There's at least two. I've been informed that Wara is indeed the biggest Corki with 28% of the team's damage.
Plugo, you have to go.
Quite big.
Rocket.
Plugo. No, not like that. Ah. Oh.
They should bait the fight, though, and use all of the packages they have.
Well, I don't know what's going on anymore, but many Corkis
died. Use your package,
in that incident,
Bear.
The great slaughter, the great Corki slaughter of 2016. Wara over the wall. Bear going to use a defensive wall off there. But forever a support. Bear, the hero that Wara needed. And Elwynd going to head back to base. Okay.
Whew. So... the second Baron buff is going to be seen once again from the TCL side. They should be able to utilize this buff with their side waves that they're currently pushing out. 10,000 gold in the lead. Not that it matters too much in the end, they're just hitting more skill shots. And that's the defining feature.
Yeah, it's pretty we don't have a statistic on skill shots hit. And like ratio of hit skill shots. Because that would be a good one for this game.
Naru's about to try and one hit Kleytos. Yeah. He didn't even know.
Kleytos doing a U-turn. He's going back to base.
Okay. Hextra. I hate Hextrinker so much.
Yeah. Ruins the hype. Can't just say what that one for the next Ezreal Corki matchup. There. He's good. Helior. Still trading away. Mystic shots coming in. Boop. He's good.
They just can't deal with the Baron minions.
Plugo.
There are a lot of packages.
Oh no, he was so close. No touchdown for him. And this may be it. There are a lot of Ezreals, but there is a lot of packages.
This is the fight.
Kleytos, he's going in. He's going to do a drive through. Plugo coming in. Kleytos trying to find that kill onto the backside. Dumbledore Doge finishing up Plugo. But the Hex Drinker keeps him alive for a little bit longer.
Wrong
not quite
the
lifesaver. Bear back to base. And now Naru, he's on cleanup duty. He's the janitor of the team. He'll find all these Corkis off to the side. And Wara left to try and clear the minions. Luckily, there is no Baron buff anymore.
No.
So,
no, there is.
Actually, no, there is. It was just some people who died. So I saw Dumbledore and I was like, they're good. Actually, not good. They're in quite a bad situation, to be honest.
Trust that man to have been dead the second he got the Baron.
It's going in onto Wara.
Speaking of dead.
Ooh, Naru, nice flash.
Or was it?
That was. The big one? Yeah. He's still alive, but Naru can't dodge this one. But they're onto the Nexus. Elwynd and Dumbledore's tag teaming down the Corkis on the fountain. Elwynd, good fall to Bear. No, he's good. We've got the rest of the Ezreals. They're just styling on the Corkis right now. Here come the True Shot Barrages. Can we kill any of the Corkis on the spawn pad? That's the dream right here. But the minions are going to finish off the game. Down goes Plugo. Rip is KDA, and that's the Nexus falling. Ezreal's reign supreme. Turkey take it home.
Redemption for the Ezreals, I suppose, for the Oceanic team.
in their team. So they have that going for them. And OC is still alive. So I think everyone's a winner.
I mean,
apart from the team that lost.
Not yet for Oceania. Still a winner in potentially there.
They're not dead. That's the main thing.
Yeah, that's
the real win. Yeah, right here. Any champions you particularly want to see in All For One?
I want to see Lissandra, personally. I think the ability to, you know, play all lanes, go to the jungle as well, in and out constantly, and just crowd control everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a really good way to actually play the game, but I also think that Zac should not exist. So if that champion is available, you have to actually take it. Like, you have to.
Yeah.
It's just so strong.
It's kind of the Nasus thing, but either way, for more on that win, Hingers is standing by with Turkey's player. We're heading over to Yanis, by the way. Take it away.
Nice juke, Pulse. Respect coming in. All right, Corki versus Ezreal. The meta evolves. Nithy, your Corki or your Ezreal pick now 1-1 in the day overall. So why don't we talk a little bit about Corki versus Ezreal, at least on a theory crafting level. When is Corki stronger? When is Ezreal stronger? What exactly happened here?
So Ezreal is stronger on the first six levels before the first base. As soon as everyone gets a first base, unless Ezreal just buys Sheen on the first base, which is not really like that good for him because he can't get the mana immune. Corki is going to win, especially once he gets the first package, second package. There's going to be like Corki is going to be doing like twice the damage of Ezreal. But after level 11, Corki is going to scale worse and worse and worse, and Ezreal is going to just get better and better and better. And just Latin America didn't really use that advantage that they had in the mid game to just win.
Yeah, and of course there were a few small moments in the game where we did see some pretty excellent use of the Ezreal ulties to get off some picks, maybe help boost that goal lead, even with what should have been a deficit here.
Yeah. Couldn't even flash forward because he would get hit by another one.
So what you're saying is it was all calculated, Methy. They'd set up a trap of Ezreal ultimates to prevent him being able to escape.
But the worst thing is you don't remember which one is the AP Ezreal, so it becomes a scenario of, like, which one do I actually want to take?
Yeah. Picking all the skins is a legitimate strategy because now you can never tell which one you actually need to flash.
Later in the game when everyone was level 16 and they were shooting ults, there was a support which did, like, no damage, but you had to flash out every ult because each of them could just have, like, the lottery ticket or the 1K damage, you know?
A little game of kind of Ezreal Russian roulette. Of course, going into the mid game, though, it did look okay for the Corkis. There was one fight coming into the bottom lane where it felt pretty good overall. It started really strong, started with a couple of Ezreal alts, but as we take a look at it now, you can see that it doesn't quite turn out as Ezreal planned.
I kind of wanted to see more uses of the package, but what was great about this fight was how difficult it is to actually chase an Ezreal because all of their skill shots are so linear and they do a surprising amount of damage. And as we were just talking about, you really don't know which Ezreal ultimate is going to pack the biggest punch. So if you're just running in a line chasing after all these Ezreals, then you're going to just make it so easy for them to get the turnaround and get all this free damage down.
I think if they really wanted to get that win, which was really important for them, I think they should have really played more with Vision, even though it's a one-for-all and everything. Ezreal has more range than Corki, and if you're just going to get kited out, so you want to just make them face-check you when you have your stronger spike and make them come to you, and then you can beta fight and win it. Because if you just, like, if they just go and fight them and try and chase them, they're just going to kite them out, and they will never win a fight.
Yeah, and instead of kind of pulling back, they stepped on the gas. They went for some really big, aggressive moves here, trying to take an early Baron as a pack of Corkis. Not quite effective.
Ultimately, this was kind of what sealed the deal for me for this game. Again, it's one for all. You don't have a tank, and so these Barons, especially when you try to take them as early as this one, are just going to rip through you, and it's going to be very easy cleanup duty, even if you don't have all five members present. So this, I mean, we've theory crafted back and forth, you know, Ezreal versus Corki, but ultimately it was that decision making that I think just really put the nail in the coffin.
Yeah. I mean, like, they could have redeemed themselves if they'd used all five packages as well as their W to spell GG. And if they'd done that, then they would have earned at least a couple style points, but they decided not to go for it, which I thought was a massive disappointment.
How could they do that, though?
You have the regular W.
I appreciate this is the one for all analysis, but even this is a little too deep for me. So keep in mind, Turkey, of course, with that win, has now secured themselves first seed in tomorrow's playoff bracket, and they are going to get matched up against the third seed of Team Fire. We'll go through that later in the day, but for now, Turkey defining themselves at the top, of course. Even if Japan finds a win in their next match, Turkey owns the tiebreaker for 1v1 wins. Now Brazil, CBLOL at 3-1 as well, and Southeast Asia holding on to hope at 2-1 on the bottom.
Big thing, though, is hope is still alive for Oceania. They needed Turkey to win there, so we're still on the boat.
Yeah, I mean, Oceania 0-3 because Latin America South ended up losing that game. They're 1-3, so all Latin South America need and Oceania need is for CIS to lose. And then Oceania for themselves, they need to win.
It comes down to two simple things. Team Fire has to win every match. Oceania has to win 1v1.
Yes. But they need to win 1v1 convincingly. Yes.
All right. Well, we're holding on to hope here for Oceania. Maybe if you're a fan of the CIS, you're holding on to hope that they can pull out a win and secure themselves first seed in Team Ice. But we're going to take a quick break. But before we go, we take a look at a region that comes all the way to us from East Asia. They're showing up big here at this tournament. It's Japan's LJL.
かなりちょっとチームとして戦っても面白いチームになるんじゃないぐらいかな、ね、非常に、バランスの取れたチームになっていると思いますね。
エビ選手は 1v1 がまあめちゃめちゃ強い、レーニングで必ず勝ちにいけるプレイヤー、味方が眼光しに行くよっていうアイルドを出した時にベイトするっていう、まあ、エビで釣るっていう
ので溜まっているミニオンを有効活用できるでしょう。そのままエビが仕掛ける、食べて吐き出して、さらにはピラー、なんとかダブルでそこを通過したいが通過できない。
タッスル選手が今日本語をかなり勉強していて、コミュニケーションもかなり取りやすい、
ガンクも積極的にしますし、敵のジャンルにもガンガン入っていきますし、
アグレッシブ一言で言うと
チームとしてミッドレーナーが一番重要っていうのもありますし、スタイルの幅があるので、その幅をどう生かすかというところがチームにとって大きな鍵になるのかなという感じがしますね。
非常にレーンを安定させる思考にあるプレイヤーかなという印象がありますね。
ここにイオンブロストのカードが突き刺さる、1キル取ったのはなんだアンソルト・サッキーミング、そのまま裏に回って D3 ダブルキルはハレッチだ、さらに3キルにつなげて、
しっかりとファームして、そして集団戦でダメージを出すというところにかなり意識を割いているプレイヤーでもある。チャンピオンプールは非常に広いというのも特徴かなと思いますね。
まあ、異名なんですけど、どこでもダラっていうのが、まあ、リーグオブレジェンドのマップのどこにでもダラがいる。
一応、おっと、いや3人決まった、ダラのウルトからランページパンダ落ちた、どこでもダラで終わるのか。
やっぱり世界に挑戦するときに武器が必要なんですよね、絶対に折れない武器っていうのは。でそれを結構曖昧にしちゃうケースっていうのが日本のなんか特徴なんですよね。
ワイルドカード地域でトップクラスのタレントが揃っているというのが日本のチームの特徴だと思います。エビ選手は韓国サーバーでチャレンジャーティアになってますし、ダー選手もタッセル選手も韓国サーバーでソロ級で練習してます。あとはセロス選手は何度も国際大会に出てますから、そういったところの個人の技術の高さであったり、ゲームへの理解度だったりといったところは非常に高いものを持っているというのを世界にアピールしたいですね。